I didn't actually know that I could work and make money in robotics as a career when I was interested in it. For me, it was more of a hobby, and I graduated high school, figured I would apply for a job because it was like my dream place to work, but I figured it was a long shot, because like, how do you end up in a place like this, right? And then the rest is history. Usually I start out with my day thinking I'm gonna do one thing, and then it ends up being something completely different. You know, you don't get bored really doing robotics. First question, what did you study in school? So I went to a technical high school for my 4 years of high school. At first I didn't know what I wanted to study for those 4 years, so I tried horticulture, graphic design, and computer repair. I ended up loving the hardware and computer repair shop, so I ended up signing up for that and did my 4 years in that, which had a robotics class once a week, which is eventually what brought me here. What got you interested in robotics? Definitely just fixing things and finding out like what's wrong, like treating it kind of like a puzzle. Sometimes we do things for the first time, like dancing, and end up breaking something. And this is helpful because this makes our robots better and more reliable. And this is a lot of what I do, whereas, you know, iterating on our current design and making things last longer. How long does it take to make a robot? So if you use Spot as an example, we've been working on this robot for maybe almost 5 or 6 years now. So it looked a little different, it was a little smaller, and at one point a little bigger than it is now. But really the last 2 or 3 years have been the distilled final version of what you see and think of now as the yellow Spot robot. Okay, here's probably a good one. Can you tell Spot what to do? So yes, Spot does not have a mind of its own. You have a controller where you can directly command Spot, kind of like an Xbox controller, or you can program it to do an autonomous mission. But all of these things you are setting up and defining for Spot. Can I drive the robot into or over a trash can or a classmate? It's a great question. And we try to bake in obstacle avoidance into our robots from a software and vision perspective. You know, if a human lays down on the floor and you're not very big, it might think you're a step that it could walk over, so I wouldn't say to try that. Does Spot have a favorite color? Well, I would like to think that it's yellow, but since robots can't think, I'm just gonna decide for it. Yes, it's yellow. Can Spot help with my homework? Classic. That is definitely not something we're working on right now. How many pounds can Spot lift? If I had a Spot, I would give it to my grandma to help her with stuff. I mean, this is actually kind of, you know, a real use case for Spot. Right now, Spot is really mostly an industrial piece of equipment, but eventually we do want Spot to work in a household environment. So I could imagine that this may come true someday. Grandma will be very happy with a Spot. Okay, how do I start building robots, or can I build a robot? You know, you can start doing like Lego Mindstorm type kits, or you can build little walking machines or things with small electric motors. You know, anything that requires even like block level programming would be a huge perk towards learning how to work with robots. Robotics is really unique, I think, because you have hardware, software, electronics. Some of our robots had engines in them. Really, it's like the full range of different experiences your people working on these robots need to have. So I think, you know, if you enjoy building things, fixing things, and being creative in a sense of like making something new, that's very much a robotics mindset. And just keep going after those things that interest you and excite you and don't feel like work. And then you can make that into a bigger hobby or maybe even a career someday. Like that's awesome.